He did indeed, but remember that he was part of Pope John Paul's Vatican, in a sense, for decades. In many ways, he was Pope John Paul's right-hand man. He was a Vatican insider. He knew how the Vatican worked. So, in a sense, his elevation to the papacy was quite a natural step. Did he have the X factor, shall we call it, that Pope John Paul II had? Well, no, he didn't. But he still traveled around the world. He was, by and large, warmly greeted wherever he went. So I think he was quite comfortable in the role, because it was certainly a role that he had been preparing for most of his life. Well, we've had reaction to his resignation from Asia, Africa, Latin America. Let's get reaction from Europe now. In the studio with us is Peter Williams from the advocacy group Catholic Voices. Thank you so much for joining us. So when you first heard that he had resigned, which is quite uncommon for a pope, certainly living memory, how did you feel, and what kind of reaction have you had from fellow Catholics in the UK?
Well, my reaction was the same as theirs, which was shock. I think a lot of them have felt a certain amount of dismay as well, because this was a pope that many of us love very deeply, and so consequently to lose him, in a sense, will be quite a jar. We don't know what's coming next. We trust the Holy Spirit that the Holy Spirit will give us a wonderful next pope. But it is very sad to see him go. This was such an amazing man, and who did such wonderful works for the church.
You say he was an amazing man. Some would say that he always suffered from the comparison to John Paul II. How do you think that this pope was special?
This pope was special because he was quieter, as it were, and he was much more, I think, and people thought of him as an elderly grandfather, but he was also extremely strong. I mean, the way that he dealt with the clerical abuse crisis, the way that he's dealt with different teachings throughout the world, the way that, in fact, he's opened up dialogue with Judaism and Islam, in so many ways, this has been a man who, because of his very deep intellect, a very gentle soul, and meekness of character, has actually been incredibly wise in the way that he's dealt with the different issues that the church has faced. And this last action, I think, is one of his wisest, because he's recognized that he had only a certain amount of strength left to do this properly, and so he's very wisely said, well, now it's time for me to go.
Some people would say that perhaps he was too meek. Some people accuse him of not dealing with the paedophile scandal strongly enough. He certainly had tensions with the Muslim world when he quoted some scripture, effectively linking the Prophet Muhammad to violence. In the UK, Catholicism is slightly in trouble. The Pope himself always said secularism is the threat to Christianity and Catholicism. So, in light of the challenges faced here, society that pulls in a way that's a modernizing way and he was more traditional, how do you think he dealt with that?
Well, I think he dealt with that by making sure that the church's witness in a society which is going down a very liberal route has actually been increasingly prophetic. That we've been saying, actually, no, the perennial teachings of the church aren't less relevant now, they're even more relevant, because as society goes away from the natural law and away from God's design for us as human beings, so the church will become much more controversial, but much more important in its prophetic witness to what the truth is about various different issues, whether it be human sexuality, whether it be just the person of Jesus Christ, and the way, in fact, he resurrects not just himself, but our whole lives as human beings.
Some Catholics have been a little disappointed because John Paul II remained pope until his death. He'd obviously been very, very sick for the last years of his papacy. Pope Benedict chose to resign. Have you sensed any disappointment among the Catholics that you've spoken to? In a sense that popes don't resign, do they? They die on the job.
Generally
because
speaking,
it's not a job.
Yes, I mean, the last pope to resign was Gregory XII back in 1415, but that was for a very specific and self-sacrificial purpose, to actually make sure that the Council of Constance could heal a schism that was then happening within the church. In the same way, whilst Pope John Paul II provided an incredibly important witness to the dignity of age and infirmity and disability, I think this pope is in doing himself a very sacrificial act, self-sacrificial act, to make sure that the papacy can be more relevant and can actually maintain it, the activity that it's supposed to do in a modern world.
Peter Williams from the advocacy group Catholic Voices here in the UK, thank you so much.
Thank you.
For joining